What does being rich mean to you? Men and women tend to define that differently. Joining us now is Jean Chatzky of HerMoney.com, who says women today have the means and the purpose to revolutionize their financial lives. What is it that you are seeing that's changed in the past 5 or 10 years that's different from before?
We have already more money and more power, and there's more where that came from headed our way. More women than men graduating from college, as well as the intergenerational transfer of wealth. Most of that money is going to flow to women because we inherit twice, both from our parents and from the husbands we outlive. And the end result is that in not so many years, women are going to control about 2/3 of the wealth in the United States. And our idea of what we want from it is very different from men.
Are women ready to take that on?
It doesn't feel quite equitable yet, even though we're moving in that direction. But we're becoming more aware of the fact that we have the ability to make changes for ourselves, for the people we love. I am hearing this thread about security and safety and savings. Women telling me they don't just want a house, they want a paid off house. They don't just want a car, they want a safe car. Women really see money as a tool to achieve our goals. We're goal focused. Men still want to win.
What do you mean want to win?
They want to be at the top of the mountain, whatever the mountain happens to be. And so women invest with an eye toward reaching our goals. Men invest with an eye toward beating the benchmarks. I actually believe men should invest a lot more like women invest. If you know what you want from your money, you can actually achieve it. If you are just reaching for more, then you're never going to be satisfied.
Tell me about the concept that you are the net rather than your savings.
Knowing that whether we're talking about investing or earning, this confidence that we are enough, we are good at this. We do not have to tie ourselves up in knots anymore to prove that we can be capable managers of our own money.
You've had these Her Money happy hours across the country. What is your favorite question to ask when you're sitting around the table?
A big one is a fill-in-the-blank question. My financial wake-up call was blank. I also like the question about whether it's okay to hide money from your significant other in your underwear drawer. That always goes well.
I like how it's so specific to the underwear drawer.
Well, you know, it has to be somewhere. Yeah. And mine is in my pantyhose, so.
Your husband's gonna go looking today.
Yeah, it's okay, he knows.